Hi, I'm Christopher Judge. I play Teal'c on Stargate SG-1. Welcome to Season 7.
Hey. Bitch!
Wow.
Bitch. I was waiting for something like that.
There was a big music sting, but I got rid of it.
Oh.
I thought it stopped short.
Yeah.
Much like my sex life.
I thought this podcast for a week.
Yeah.
A couple of weeks.
Get Into Gate. Yes, we are back after, look, it was going to be a week and it's been about four, and welcome to the fifth weekend, and here we are. We finally got a podcast back, the full Get Into Gate team all back together for the first time in a long time, and we are talking about, as Christopher Judge mentioned, Season 7. We're here, boys. Woo! We've done it. We're here.
Yeah, baby.
Rhys is going to be really excited when we talk about why it's so exciting for a lot of other people in this room, but welcome to Maddie, Brendan, and Rhys.
Hello.
I'm Mitch.
Guys.
Let's get into the old synopsis of the show, and then we throw it over to Rhys and see what he thought about the special
events. Are we doing the double up? Are we doing the double up here?
I think we should.
Two?
Yeah, it's one of those, like, technically not two-parters, right? Because it's Fallen and Homecoming.
Well, on the wiki it says this is 2 out of 3, and then Homecoming's 3 out of 3.
Right.
So you can consider the last episode of Season 6. And these is
that's a stretch.
Combined.
Kind of weird, like little trilogy.
Hey, I didn't do it. I didn't write it.
That's a long stretch because there's months in between, potentially. We'll get to that.
While searching for the lost city of the ancients on a distant planet, SG-1 is stunned to find Daniel Jackson alive and in human form, but stripped of his memory and clothes. O'Neill convinces Daniel to return with them to the SGC, where he is reinstated for a daring mission to destroy Anubis' powerful new superweapon. And then in Homecoming, Anubis attacks Jonas' home planet's Kelowna when he learns it has mines of Nequadria, a powerful energy source he can use for his super weapon. The Kelownans seek help from SG-1, specifically Jonas, who may be the only one who can save his homeland and ensure its peaceful future. Collectively written by Robert C. Cooper, Joe Malozzi, and Paul Mully in the second part, both episodes directed by Martin Wood. Rhys, what did you think, buddy?
Hated it.
Can't remember.
And that's the end of Season 7. Thank you very much.
Not only from the start, where you just see his, like, you know, Ace Ventura naked body just lying on the ground
position.
But then the opening credits, I'm like, God, I hope this is one of the opening credits where Rhys goes, oh, I wanted to make myself a drink, because it doesn't even carry on from last season. It's just like Michael Shanks and kind of guest starring Corin who? What? Bye!
Not even that. They totally did him dirty. No. He just gets Corin Nemec. Not an Corin Nemec or special guest star Corin Nemec, just Corin Nemec.
Yeah.
That is fucking
But you think for at least a week or 2 weeks, fuck with the audience a little bit and just pretend like things are not going to change. Daniel, okay, he survived whatever happened to him at the end of last season.
Mate, Michael Shanks would not have that.
My picture
is going to be in the opening credits.
Yeah. I want my nipple in the opening. It better fucking be there.
I suppose everyone knew he was going to die before the episode aired, so I guess they probably all knew that he was coming back too.
Yeah.
So then we just went, we'll just set up our credits so we don't have to redo them in 2 weeks' time.
Yeah.
And away we go.
You're right. It's probably was better served watching it live rather than now, because that was the first thing I read down. I'm like, God, I'm actually really thinking about Rhys now, because it's ruined the next two episodes or this double episode about how it's going to end. I don't know what Rhys knew or thought you knew going into it and what was going to happen.
That's
when you
why
did
you
see
should
Daniel.
Always go by my life's motto. Never read.
I did, and that's why we succeeded so well in grade 12 English.
Absolutely.
Yeah, not a pencil put to paper that entire year. Well, look at us now.
But it was Boxer Boys. It wasn't real English.
We graffitied a lot in our notepads.
Yeah.
You read and write? Yeah, I just choose not to.
I don't like it. Of scrapbooking in my diary. There's two Matrix movies that year.
May 25, Reloaded, yay, countdown to then.
Every essay at school was just letters from magazines cut out and stuck on.
There was.
Like a
Which
psychopath.
Which is ironically more work than actually writing.
Actually, like a ransom note.
Like a psychopath, we actually did dedicate the back pages of our diary to, not a psychopath, but like a bloke, one of the cool guys in our grade. We called him Mentor because he was just so cool.
Everything
he did, we're just like, that's how you be cool, man. So we just wrote a list, the mentor list. It was like, you sit backwards on a chair, mentor. Something like Zoltan out of Doom.
Such a dickhead. He was such a douchebag. Oh, he had his hat backwards. I'm like, this is a Catholic school hat. with a Velcro piece at the front, so it's not even fitted. And he sat backwards talking to dog chicks. I'm pretty sure that's what it was. That was the
dog
list.
Yeah, it was very it was like 2A. Sit backwards in your chair, 2A, and talk to dog chicks.
Because but that's a theme to me. If his hat's backwards and he's sitting backwards on a chair, then it's like it's like he's passing through the backside of his body because everything else is facing
We'll never understand.
He's back to front.
That's why he was mental. You know? We can only learn from him, not become mental.
Mental or mentor?
Mentor. He's our mentor.
Yeah.
Who was it?
Craig.
Never heard of him.
Yeah,
never
didn't think so. Yeah. Shout out to Craig.
Oh, you mean mentor?
He's a big SG1 fan. No doubt.
And did you guys go with mentee or protege? What do you prefer? If you're going to be, if you're going to have a mentor... Do you prefer to be a mentee or a protege?
I was going to leave that to him.
I was going to say Mentos.
Yeah, I was going to say Minty is the Molly.
I love a Mentos.
Absolutely.
Who doesn't?
Any flavour. I'll take any flavour Mentos.
Get the white Choco Mentos into you. My God.
I'll take a whole shaft. Whole stick of those. Yeah, whole stick of those.
Yeah.
White and dark.
Yes.
Okay.
Any colour. Any colour.
All sorts of Mentos.
Stargate SG-1.
Yeah, look, new season, new disc, new DVD menu. Mate, that computer image running through, what is it?
Like the Alpha site?
Off-world base, yeah, Alpha site. Yeah. That was sweet.
In my mind, it's where, like, Walter and Hammond are in this episode. You know how they go? To me, that's where it is. That's.
And I just got to tell you, I mean, Walter with contact lenses, what a handsome motherfucker.
Absolutely.
Jesus. That's all.
And first time off world in this double parter.
Well, no, Hammond's been off world.
No, Gary.
Walter.
Right.
Walter's his first time off world, mate. Mm. He was just champing at the bit.
Absolutely.
Loving it.
And then they're like, all right, quickly get out. Yeah, quickly go home. Yeah.
What? I just got here.
I've literally just setting up. Now they're going to kill you. Yeah. Oh, fine. Leave everything.
Yeah, I'm not sure why they were there in the first place.
Thanks, Daniel.
Yeah.
Couldn't they just monitor from the safety of Earth through the Stargate? Like through radio chatter? Like what?
Yeah.
I feel like that's more safe than like, you know, 4 tent poles and a bit of canvas. Like,
yeah.
You could just imagine the conversation they had beforehand though. Hammond says to Walter, well, you know, we'll go off world again someday. And he goes, oh, I've never been off world before. Oh, you haven't? Well, I guess we could set something up on this planet and treat you to your first off-world experience.
Maybe all the lower downs have to like accrue flex days before they can go off-world. Yeah. And Walter's finally accrued enough time.
This counts as our Christmas party.
Yeah, to allow like 3 hours off-world. So he's like, let's go. We're taking the whole bloody base.
Yeah, true. So we know the Stargate's on level 3, judging by Jonas's little elevator trip.
28.
Well, he gets in the lift and he goes, level 3, please.
Oh, does he?
I didn't even notice that.
I'm pretty sure. Look, it was a month ago when I watched this.
Yeah. Did you see who was in the lift with him, though, eating the cookie? That's Martin Wood. That was his director cameo.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I noticed he bumped into Syla.
Yeah, he was like, Sergeant Syla.
Jonas, if he remembers everything, why would he get Syla and...
Oh, he's just excited.
Tyler.
He's just excited.
That's how excited he is.
He's lost his superpower. He's that excited.
I'm getting written out, man. I'm forgetting everything.
He's so excited to be unemployed next week. He's so excited.
Oh, shit. So,
Danny boy.
The thing was, like, Naked Daniel comes back.
Yes.
He's laying in.
How hard were you?
Mate, I was like, if that was Jonas. But the way he was laying just weirded me out.
So bad. Like, you could easily, like, if Terminator can do it, they could have done it. Like, he could have just had one leg over covering his, you know.
Your dick's not that big, mate.
Right?
Take both your hands away.
Both handing it.
It was very fetal.
But one was, like, on his hip, like, hugging his
hip.
Yeah.
His left
I feel like
hand
if he'd been
right
if he'd been covered in like slime or goo, like he'd literally just been like a baby just given birth or something like that. You could have bought that, like he'd just been.
Or even bald
out.
Like Neo would have been sick.
Or even just not naked.
He's very pale. He's very
have
pale.
Have some like, ascension clothes.
Yeah. I would have gone
yeah,
and
it was
a
just
spray
something.
Tan.
How, what would you have given?
Yeah, for sure. It was so white.
If the first words, yeah, they come over, they're like, right, he goes, where's my sweater? Is it Ascension cardigan or Ascension sweater?
Yeah.
Ascension sweater.
Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
Sorry.
But
it's
it was
very
so bold and the beautiful. What's your name?
I don't remember.
I don't know.
Straight down the lens. I don't know.
But look at my right nipple. It's kind of an oval shape. But it's still hot.
And I had a sweet wax before this.
And then Carter comes in and goes, "Oh, Daniel, so happy to see you." And he's just like, "Whatever."
Whoa.
Just walks away again.
Like, he was like that last season. I don't know why he's surprised that he doesn't remember.
It's like, "Oh, you mustn't remember me." "No, I do. I remember everything." Like, the only thing I remember. There was a lot of remembering stuff between "I don't know what my name is" to when they showed up. And he's still just like, "Oh, I'm just kind of hoping you guys would never find me. I could just live in this robe for the rest of my life." Like, hell, Daniel, like, be grateful about something.
That's what I didn't get when they walked up and they're like, "Daniel," and he just looked at him and just like didn't care. I'm like, I could under later when they say to him, why don't you want to know who you are, blah blah blah, he's like, "Do I want to?" All that. But surely that's when you wake up and you don't know anyone, no one knows you, and you're like, "Okay, well, you know, I guess I need to make the most of this life. I may never realize who I am." And then like a day later, some people come from, you know, another planet and go, "Hey, we know you." And then, of course, you'd go, "Shit, do you really? Like, what are the odds of that?"
Yeah, tell me everything. Is it tomorrow?
Well, that's
prove that you know me. I'll double-check your stats.
That's the interesting weird disconnect that I had, is how much time had passed from when he woke up naked to when SG-1 arrived. Because all they say is it's been 2 moons. And it's like, okay, well, for us, that could potentially be 2 months.
Well, they could be two moons.
Could that just be 2 days? Could that just be 2 nights?
Could they have 3 moons on the planet?
Well, yeah, that's true. So it's like, A, why did Omar sort of drop him there? And then B, it's like, well, why do they choose that particular time and all that kind of stuff as well? If he did hang around for 2 months.
Yeah. And what a coincidence that they just happened on the last of the list. Hey, why don't we go to the last list? Oh, okay. Hey, Daniel. Yeah.
Well, I mean, Omar knew that they were going there, clearly. She's an all-knowing, powerful being.
Right.
Maybe she thought they were going to get there a lot earlier, but Jonas was just taking too long mistranslating. So she's just like popped into his front and just been like tinkered with his memory. And he's like, "Oh, I can't know where we have to go now." Because she's like, "Just go and get him already."
I just like the idea that he did work it out. He's like, "What? If we're going to find Daniel somewhere, this must be the plan." Oh, nothing. This is the Daniel plan. Oh, so, no, I'm not working on anything. No, this research just isn't going anywhere, Jack. In general, I'm sorry.
I feel like the blue outfits were a weird choice too for like a nomadic tribe that are just sort of living, just moving from place to place to place.
Mm. Well, clearly they were from a water world.
Yes.
Atlantis.
They're from Atlantis.
Well, actually, I would say the Atlanteans probably dress worse.
Yes. They did. Correct.
They gave Jackson his whole own tent, but.
Yeah.
Mm. Like, we're travelers. We've been here for a while. We got an extra super large tent if you want to camp in that for a couple of months.
Does it have an ensuite? It's in my contract.
Well, clearly they gave him a lot too.
Because that was the biggest tent.
When he decides to go back with them, he jumps out the tent and he puts on a little satchel bag.
Yeah.
He was naked in the last scene. What has he got to take with him?
He's just gone to different people's tents. And, that's nice. Yeah, well,
I mean, he doesn't get his glasses till he gets back to SG-1, gets back to Earth. So it's like, what has he got in his little satchel bag?
But he's literally got nothing.
This isn't pure gold, damn it.
It's actually just his toilet bag. It's filled with leaves for wiping. He just doesn't know what it's going to be like when he gets to Earth. He's like, just in case.
This is, I think, I've said this previously, Daniel was my favourite starting and then it gradually changes to Jack. And this is definitely, like, obviously over season 6, Jack was my favourite. But then Daniel doesn't come back. Daniel's always dead for me, whereas Michael Shanks definitely comes back.
Yeah.
This isn't Daniel.
I think in an interview, Michael Shanks actually said because of what's happened, he stops being Dr. Daniel Jackson and he's kind of just Daniel Jackson now. Like, he's obviously been through a lot, so Michael Shanks deliberately played him a different way. I actually love Daniel this season.
I do too, but just this particular episode where I was like, this isn't Daniel.
Mm.
It was weird. Like,
right up until the very last scene of Homecoming, it was like, I guess.
It was a little odd, and it was very quick to, like, you know, from, you know, opening scene, he's naked on a planet, to 15, 20 minutes to the episode, it's like they're already on board Anubis's ship, running around with Jonas, decrypting doors and, you know, finding secret plans. And I'm like, whoa.
Doesn't remember any of his training or experience that he's gone through.
You do this a lot? Yeah. It's all coming back to me.
Go with Jonas. You'll be fine.
When was this episode? They could have like really done a Born Identity type like two-parter where he didn't remember anything. Like, yes. You know, that moment when he doesn't know his name, but he's like, I know that, you know, at this altitude, I could run this fast without, you know, breaking into a sweat and I could take that guy. And he's, you know, like he knew everything without actually knowing anything about himself. Like, it would have been cool to see Daniel just be like.
That's Jonas's
powers,
this
is 2003.
sorry.
He knows number plates.
I guess they kind of did that with the tablet, right? Like, I don't know how I can read ancient. I just can.
Yeah. But that was such a condescending Daniel's like, wrong.
Yeah.
But they're your notes. But you still said, wrong.
Yeah. Still wrong.
I'm even smarter than myself, it seems. Yeah. Okay, obviously.
You thought that I was the smartest and you were listening, reading that bullshit. And that's wrong.
I'm so smart that even I'm stupider than I am.
What I found was really awkward is it's like when he starts kind of starting to remember stuff and he finally remembers Sharae. And he remembers her name and he gets all excited and he runs into Teal's room to say, this is Sharae. I remember. And it's like, Teal's like, oh, fuck, I've got to have this awkward conversation all over again.
And O'Neill killed her, remember?
see that staff weapon of mine leaning up in the corner? Jack took it and fucking shot it. Yeah.
Jonas That's told the thing, like,
first he shot his son, then he shot your wife. That's why I left my kid off world.
He's crazy, man. He's crazy.
Still not sure about my wife, how that happened.
He killed my wife's lover. Killed my wife.
He beat the shit out of my son.
He started a Jafar rebellion.
I was happy with my god.
Insane. I wanted to be a fireman. Yeah, he didn't even say anything. Eh? He's just like, she's dead, and he's just like slowly nods. Yep.
You did it.
Just Jack walks past the room, sticks his head in. Yeah, killed her. Yeah.
What I find really cool.
It would have been great if he had a shot of him walking in and then just quickly moonwalking back out again.
but eating the whole time, like Brad Pitt motions, like, Tilkota.
He just walks in eating and just nonchalantly drops the mission file from that episode and walks out.
Oh, nice photo. That's the one Tilk killed.
With a picture of Tilk and his staff weapon sitting over her, like she was some kind of fresh kill in the wild.
Like he's a Midwest dentist. And she's a rhino.
The only time Tilk's ever smiled in the entire series is just like Cat Sharae.
Oh, God.
It's the only time I smiled, to be honest.
Oh, is this going to displease Daniel? Oh, God, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Rhys, I'm not sure why, but you seem to have not mentioned Carter's new hairstyle yet.
Yeah, dude, what's up?
Funny, man, because I was watching this with my wife and she goes, her hair's really annoying me. And I said, don't start hair chat with me, love. She goes, it's too long, needs to be cut. I'm like, hey, tell the boys.
No, I like kind of season four long or last season short, I guess.
No, I'm a fan of season seven, season eight.
No, it's like she's put a finger in an electricity socket. It's like Marv from Home Alone now.
No, looks like she's just woken up from Window of Opportunity.
God, yeah.
End of season four was
Jack
too short
her brains
and
out.
Oh, I see now.
Hair's everywhere.
Absolutely.
Remember she got taken over by the electrical entity and her hair was like really, really short?
Yeah,
I didn't like that. That was too short.
What else is good?
I take offense to that. I've got extremely short hair.
That's offensive.
Offensive to everyone with short hair.
Oh, tough.
Did I mention you owe me $50?
That was
really good.
A little one-liner from
we
Jack
get paid?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It'd be funny if we do. Tilk doesn't.
Don't tell him.
Don't tell him what pay is.
Does Jonas? Because he's an alien too. So it's like, would he have gotten paid? What would he have done with that money?
Well, they're not allowed off base, are they, without being supervised? So
yeah.
I guess if they need something, they'll just pull out the old Air Force credit card.
They just pay him books.
Pays for his cable connection to get all those extra channels with all the weather channels.
Yeah.
Yeah. Weather. That's what extra channels you'd get.
But I wonder if they'd let him out more because one of the reasons they didn't let Teal'c out is because of his symbiote. So I wonder if they'd just let Jonas just wander about.
Oh, yeah, he's there.
Because he's no threat.
He's got a place.
He's got Daniel's old place. Yeah. He's living in that.
Sam's basement. building his own Stargate.
And then, like, looking at the Stargate at the as the mini Stargate and going, I wonder how they got it in here, drinking a cup.
Don't.
It doesn't fit up the stairs.
Don't remind me of that, because I actually really like Jonas in this episode. I feel like the one thing Jonas was missing all through season six was scenes with Daniel Jackson. Like, it seems like that brings out the best in him.
He's like the,
they were great. They could, like, chat on the same level as each other. And then, like, Corin doing that jump through the, like, the fritzing force field, like the force shield. That was brilliant. Like, he gave that everything. I was like, respect for that. That was good.
Oh, didn't Daniel leave him for dead?
Yeah.
Daniel's like, oi, give me a boost into this vent. Shuts the vent.
Apparently,
the vent was shut when
he didn't even
Jafar
know the Jafar were coming.
Yeah. Apparently,
Oi, give us a lift up. Oh, I can't.
Michael Shanks is actually in the audio commentary with Martin Wood, and that was a surprise to him as well, because apparently they shot a beat where Daniel is supposed to kind of turn around and see that there's not really enough time, and then they cut that out. So just like Daniel just took off and did not give a shit.
Let me find an escape pod real quick. So the question I had again was, why didn't they call the Asgard for help?
Help for what?
Just to, you know, how Anubis was going around blowing up planets.
Oh, that
just
little thing.
Give us a hand. They didn't have to, they wouldn't have had to rely on Lord Yu.
They use their go-to excuse, oh, we're busy with replicators, mate. Sorry, we're busy.
Yeah, but aren't they all on that slow-me-down planet?
Yes.
Yeah, but they...
Yes, they are.
They have used that excuse since then, though, haven't they? They're like, oh, we're, you know, working on ways to defeat the replicators or something.
You've got plenty of time, guys. Just
dodgy.
Give us a hand here.
You got at least six more episodes.
At least.
So, Rhys, how did you feel about... saying goodbye to Jonas?
I was a lot more upset than I was saying goodbye to Daniel, to be honest.
Stop it.
I don't know if it was like I didn't believe that Daniel had actually died last season or season before.
It's because you've seen the season 7 box set.
Yeah,
well,
probably.
He did kind of just like dissolve into a glowy thing and then go through the Stargate.
Yeah, so he wasn't actually dead. Well, obviously he's f-ing alive now. But I think with Jonas, it's sort of like... he went through, you know, went and talked to each one of them. It was like, well, you know, thanks. And, you know, actually said a goodbye and then walked out. I'm just like, man, gone into politics. Fuck that.
That goodbye was really awkward too. I feel like, really? They're going to wait until like the gates open and it's like, we're chewing power here, guys. to give the goodbye. Speed like up. They're not going to buy him a fucking cake or something. Like, have a little party in the fucking briefing room.
Yeah, well,
something.
Maybe the party, but I just feel like the gate has to be open because it's probably been trial and error before when they're farewell people. Like, you know, it's really awkward. Like, if you go to, like, you know, here in this office, I know that I've walked someone to the lift and you say goodbye to them and then you hit the button for them. Courtesy, I'll hit the lift for you.
Yeah.
And the lift isn't on your floor. And then it's like, well, do I make you wait for the lift or do I wait for the lift with you and I've already said goodbye? So imagine doing that. It's like, all right, Jonas, yeah, really sorry to see you go, mate. But anyway, we've got Daniel back and we like him better. Anyway, hit it, Walter. Chevron 1, encoded. Wait for 2 minutes.
They get all the way to
Jonas sitting there with his thumb up his ass, like, God, I can't wait to get back home.
They get all the way to 7 and they can't establish a lock because it's like his planet's been destroyed in the meantime.
Will not lock.
You and Daniel are going to have to bunk tonight. Sorry.
So I thought, Rhys, I thought you might be having a bit of a hard time dealing with, you know, saying goodbye to Jonas and our beloved Daniel coming back. So. Here it is, and I've wrapped it in the box of shame. I physically have a little something for you.
Jesus. Is it your bad memories wrapped up in...
No, it's just a little memento of Jonas's time.
Do I get to keep the box of shame?
No. You can have what's in it. You know what's in it. It's your very own...
Is it a dildo?
Oh, it will
Jonas
be, that's for sure.
Action figure!
Yes.
You paid for a quarter of that, by the way.
Sensational. What? This came out of my bank? I've got to be honest, it looks nothing like him.
No, it really doesn't.
But, you know, the correct outfit.
Yeah, no, he's even got his
and
little zap.
Also, his hands are perfect size for your schlong.
Would you call it a schlong?
Tinky.
Schlort.
Your tinky.
Schlort. Chode.
Tinky.
Oh, thanks, guys, including myself.
That's okay. Brendan's going to get a Dr. Weir when once we get to Atlantis.
Oh, God,
so.
Please save my money.
I'd rather sign up to Stargate Command. Is that really supposed to be Jonas?
Yeah, that's the one and only.
You sure it's not Cameron Mitchell?
No. He looks even worse, actually.
It's not Robert Patrick from Terminator 2, is it?
Yeah, it could be.
I tell you what, he's not light on gear. Like, that vest is full.
What is he carrying?
Just books.
Heaps of books.
Just books. Daniel's do-rag.
Magnifying glass.
Pages of texts.
Now, do you get to play with Damo Edwards now? What does he have? Doesn't he have a...
Yeah. He's got a lot. Well. He's got a bunch.
Yeah, right. That's right. He has a Jonas and he despises Jonas. And we're like, why would you get it? Yeah.
One of the great patrons.
To be fair, the only way I could actually get that was to buy it in a lot with other figurines. but the others are spoilers. So as we can reveal them, I'll reveal them. But the other three are actually...
Are they all mine?
Spoilers for Rhys. Oh, if you want,
did we pay for those too?
Well, they're a quarter mine. we get one each.
Cool. You happy with that, mate? Because
absolutely, that's bedside table.
You better be
type stuff. Glad it's not a fucking Daniel one, that's for sure.
Going back to when they were saying goodbye to Jonas, kind of felt bad for him because no one ever really gave him a nice response. Even I was expecting Carter to, but she's like, "I've been burned by Daniel too many times."
You get a hug and
like,
that's it.
See you next time, buddy.
Mm. I thought Jax was pretty perfect, actually.
You earned it.
From a guy like Jack, that's fucking top notch, I reckon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Get the fuck out.
I mean,
you earned this exit, now fuck off my world.
But if that was Teal'c leaving, if that was Teal'c going back to Tulok, he would have got more than that. He would have got more than that from Jack.
Got a blowjob, mate.
Sure.
Jack pulls up his sleeves and got your face tattooed on my arm, bro.
Takes off his cap. He's got his very own gold emblem burnt into his forehead.
Blood Brothers.
Says Teal'c. Teal'c's autograph.
But it does reinforce, though, how much I hate Kelowna's. Like, all those other Kelowna's that we sort of meet in the second half in Homecoming, I just want to uppercut every single one of them.
I spent all that episode waiting for Spider-Man to come in.
Yeah.
Homecoming. Oh.
I was waiting for that one.
Well, did you recognise the Ambassador Noah, like the female chick there, little
did
short
I?
With black hair?
Can't say I did.
She played Catherine Langford in 1969.
Yeah.
Sam Actress.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
She's Eli's mum too.
Oh, yeah, she is too, isn't she?
I think so.
That's right.
You'll figure that out, Rhys.
Eli, yep.
Yeah,
mum.
Keep that.
Excellent.
One of the great characters.
Don't even book of spoilers.
And old mate, that old guy at the very, very start telling the stories, which, side note, is basically what a conversation with my mum is like these days. Like, just she'll tell a story and then take a breath and start telling the exact same story all over again.
Yeah.
It's that bad.
Right.
But that's the Kingslayer from Need. Remember that old that was...
Need.
Need, where...
Did you say the Kingslayer?
The Godslayer. Oh. Did I say Kingslayer?
I think so.
Freudian slip from Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
No, from Need, when Daniel got...
His sister butt.
The chick who was obsessed with trees, the stage 5 clinger, and then Daniel was addicted to the sarcophagus.
Yeah, okay.
That was the dad. Yeah. I killed a guaud who come here, whatever right. it is, while he's eating his soup.
Yeah, okay.
I killed a guaud who ruled here. That guy.
Good story.
Yeah.
Jesus, yeah, we went the long way around, didn't we?
Hang on.
I got something else here. Oh, now, okay. It's probably the greatest thing you've ever heard.
Oh, don't oversell it.
It's a song
did you hear the,
that I wrote.
Did you hear the opener to Maddie's segment?
Say what?
It's a song that I wrote.
It's a song that I wrote.
Oh, geez, hold on to your f***ing hats, ladies and gentlemen.
That I wrote. What's that song?
Look, I'm in mourning, Maddie. Shut the fuck up. Jonas is a big part of my heart.
Oh, don't tell me it's another Elton John song.
Oh, God.
I tried to bookend Jonas's.
Did Elton John write a song called Jonas?
No, but...
Listen.
F*** me.
I tried to bookend this the Jonas saga.
This is a
couple of Elton John songs.
Jonas.
It's not a diss song. I'm in mourning. For Jonas, he's left. We love him. Oh, I love him. No. Rhys definitely does.
Now I'm worried.
Mitch does. Yeah. Maddie doesn't. That's fine. Now, because Jonas is leaving, this one I've called Jonas in the wind.
Oh, for f- sake.
Hold on to your hats.
I like the candles, ladies and gentlemen.
You've got douche chills already.
Goodbye, Jonas Quinn. Yes. So you have grown in a heart you have to face, you stood aside while Daniel Jackson died. You brought us some Nequadra.
It's called Nequadra.
And they said it poisoned your brain. They set you on that pedestal and they changed your DNA. And immediately your meal was cooked with a candle in the wind. And you faded through the Stargate. Then my pain set in. And I wish I didn't hate you, but I was just a kid. Your candle burned out long before your phantom never did.
Phantom never did.
Oh, shit. No douche chills there.
Oh, all right. One of the great ones.
That was actually really good.
That was... Tell you what, they're getting better as you go along.
Guys.
When's the album come out?
If
mate, I'm touring next week.
if we ever discover time travel, one of us needs to go back and slip that into a tape deck on the day of Princess Di's funeral.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Like, that would just be the greatest ever.
Well, history will show the two times that song has ever been at its strongest and most meaningful. Is Princess Di's funeral
and right here.
Jonas Quinn.
Farewell.
Jonas
Quinn.
Farewell. Through the Stargate.
Head
on back to your planet with all those shit people that need uppercuts.
Lord Yu's getting on a bit, isn't he?
Yeah.
Of which. What? He's getting on.
Oh, God. Speaking of which,
speaking
I agree
of
with
which,
you.
Yeah, people are losing their memory.
Yeah. And, yeah, look. He just needs to retire. Yeah.
I do like his first prime, though.
Yeah.
I think that's a nice little sort of difference rather than just being the big booming, you know, cliche like Anubis's first prime and, you know.
Prime dick.
All those guys.
Prime dick.
I do like that. But fun fact, he's like the first prime side dude, like the giant 7 foot tall dude standing next to him when like when he's standing on the Peltak and then also when he goes to interrogate Teal'c in the jail cell. That's Peter Cudmore. That's Colossus from the X-Men movies.
Oh, really?
That was like one of his first roles.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I did not know that. I didn't even pick up on that.
Yeah, I didn't see anybody
big,
like
tall
that.
Hunker.
Oh, I would take Peter Cudmore over. Wait, is it Peter?
Mind you, I watched this 6 weeks ago.
Sorry, Daniel Cudmore. I'd take him over Daniel Jackson.
Yeah.
Colossus is a handsome man.
You could
man.
Sleep between Colossus. Those pecs of his. Like, he is a he's a beast of
but
a man.
But what about Daniel's nipple?
Oh, I didn't notice it. You seem to be.
Well, I'm just looking at a picture of it because it's on the wiki page.
Oh, is it?
Like literally the fourth time you've brought it up.
It's because I'm literally looking at it. It's turning me on a bit.
Fourth hard you've got in a row over it.
Stop touching me, Mitch.
Ironically.
No.
Not while I'm looking at Daniel's nipple,
those waxed arms of yours.
It's not the last time you see his nipple in this show either. So.
No, you're right about that. You get two next time.
Too much nudity, if you ask me.
Ooh, wait till you see Daniel wrapped in an American flag. Yeah. Ooh, Jesus. That'll do things to you.
Yeah, make me want to kill myself.
Uh-oh. Yeah, we've lost Rhys. Season 8.
No, I like the first prime as well. But he did come around. Maybe I know he had needed to move on for episode minute count, but he did come around to them pretty quick because he's like they're like come to our side. This is our plan. He's like, no, I would be disobeying my master. I must obey him. They're like, yeah, but by disobeying him, that'd actually be obeying him. And he's like. You're right. Let's do your plan. Yeah.
And it's to his benefit, But why did he start telling Teal'c about his bad memory and shit? It's like,
yeah. It's like
that's weird.
First prime. You're his first prime. Yeah. It's like, why would you be giving that kind of stuff up so quickly?
Especially to Teal'c, who's like the main adversary of the Gould.
Sure. Yeah.
The Gould.
Certainly the face of it, yeah.
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 Maybe he's just keen to get out. You know, like when if your boss is going to die and he's an absolute prick.
Yeah.
I imagine having the world's shittest boss for 1,000 years. He'd be like, yeah, sick, he's going to be dead and I'm joining the rebellion. It's going to be sick.
I think that's called marriage, isn't it?
Wow.
says
I didn't say that.
I didn't record myself saying that.
How was your first anniversary a couple of weeks ago, Rhys? Good?
Felt like 10. Nah, it was very
Wait till 10.
Wait till 10. You want to kill the system, Lord.
I did like that moment early on before Daniel sort of decided to, or Arum at the time, I guess, before he decided to rejoin us, the moment that he and Sam had in the tent, and then she was being so nice to him, he was like, he basically said, did we bang? Is that what you're being? Right. And she's like, no, we're just friends. And she didn't even say family. Like, I thought by now they'd be like, no, you're family. She's like, no, we're just really, really good friends.
Really, really good friends.
We're just picking you up, plopping you straight in the friend zone.
Yeah.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, I sort of questioned that because I'm like, why is he asking her that for? But I think it was his way of testing her of like, are you telling me to come back because you're being selfish, because you need to get something out of this as well, because you miss me?
Yeah.
Or do you want me to come back because we're a team?
Yeah,
because
you want me to be your naked one? Or?
I'm pretty sure I want to break up.
Do we?
Because I've already had sex with three women here.
And one dude, that old dude who called me Aram. I'm like, get it on, old man.
As soon as we finished, he forgot that we did it, so he did it again.
And he banged him. He's like, I remember I'm straight now, so that's cool. At least I know.
Do we have a child that I was trying to abandon on this planet? Are you trying to get me back when I don't have a memory?
I don't get paid. I can't give you child support.
But you know, even if that was a chance, he'd still go back because he thought there was a chance he might get laid out of it because he's a stupid, stupid man.
That's so true.
It's like, no, we're not together. We've never been together. Never will be together. He's like, so you're telling me there's a chance? All right. What's your other plan? Like, perfect. It could be a hell. You know what? You're the other one.
Let's risk it. Risk it.
Yeah, it didn't take him long to make up his mind after that, eh?
No.
He wouldn't even know if he has AIDS or anything. Jeez. Any kind of STD.
Yeah, true. Yeah.
And there's that one AIDS reference for the season. Starting early.
For the season?
One that'll get left in, at least.
The episode.
Was there ever anything between us?
There's that line.
Mm-hmm.
And there's something that we debated about. We were talking about it that we're wondering, why does that line exist there?
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's because she's saying so many things that are so
personal
and so sentimental and so loving that mm-hmm. he forgets what kind of friends that they actually once were. And that's where the strength of it lies, where he's sitting there saying, only people that really love each other say that. So we asked the woman, did we have a relationship? No, we were just that good friends. Mm-hmm. And that's where I think makes him come out of the tent. He goes, well, if that's the case, then I must be. It's worth having a look to try and figure this all out, which was the big turning point for him.
Yeah.
And if it were the other way around, you'd tell the woman that yes.
Yeah. Yeah. That's true. Exactly. Absolutely. Yeah.
We're married.
I want to give Amanda a tapping, if you know what I mean.
Well, and then apparently he didn't have so many qualms about when he finally met up with Dr. Fraser again.
You should have been asking Fraser if you'd ever had a relationship.
No, I was playing that. I was playing that. I asked every chick on the base if I'd ever had a relationship with him.
Nicely done.
Cool.
She's like, yes, I do. He goes, don't you have a daughter? Yeah, no, we definitely didn't have a relationship. Yes, we did, Daniel. Pretty sure I wouldn't have. Yeah, no.
P.S. I know your PIN code.
I did notice something when Jonas was leaving. It's weird when you have a rewatch because you notice things the second time you haven't seen the first time. I have a little bit of a clip here. See if you guys can pick it up. Something Jonas says.
Uh-oh.
Hey, Daniel. Need my fist?
Not too much.
I'm off to London, England.
So weird.
Is this another Austin Powers reference?
So lost.
Well,
Jensen, feed my fish. Not too much. Up to London, England.
Oh, right.
Is that Austin Powers? Shit.
Yeah.
In many ways, Big Boy never left, sir. He's always after the same quality meals as competitive prices.
Brendan. That's one.
Oh, shit. This is a complete episode. AIDS and Austin Powers.
Hang on, I haven't mentioned Marvel yet. Hold up. We should give out bingo cards.
Yes. You know? I like that. Get Into Geek bingo. Old mate is obviously number one.
Cooper, obviously.
Cooper too, yeah.
Well, to keep going with that then, new season. New segment.
Oh, Stargate bingo.
Yeah. We beat you to it. Woo!
Well, after the, you know, rousing down, success that around the world was last season.
Please don't.
I racked my brain trying to think of a good sort of recurring segment we could introduce for this season.
That wouldn't have taken long.
I had nothing. I got nothing.
Thank you, mate.
Thank you. And it occurred to me that I really, like, I've said it a lot, and I've had a lot of people, actually, while we were on our break, a lot of people slipping into the DMs going, A, when are you coming back? And B, I love season 7 so much. So I think that's why it was so much torture for everybody that we were away for so long, because I just wanted us to crack into season 7.
Oh, geez, can't we just have 5 minutes, guys? Jeez.
No.
Can't
we go to LA for a bit?
Let's have a f***ing holiday. I mean, Jesus, we went over Christmas and New Year. Give us a break.
And your wedding.
Absolutely.
And your honeymoon.
Honeymoon, everything.
Yeah.
Well, Gibson Brothers released too during that period, so you're welcome.
That was during Rhys's anniversary weekend.
Live,
he's like,
too.
No, I've got to get drunk with Brendan now. Okay.
Absolutely.
Live, we didn't pre-record a thing. Just all live. Yep, all live. So I realised going forward for season 7, I love it so much, there's maybe 2 episodes towards the back end that aren't great, which is about as bad as I can say about it. I'm going to find it really hard to be impartial this season, like to find bad things about these episodes because I love them so much. So I thought what I'll do is I'll introduce a new segment, and I don't know. I've got 2 options. We're going to live, just, you know, we're going to figure out. I've got 2 options for what we can call this segment. So we can either call it
Spoil Everything for Rhys.
No, I've been doing
that. It's already
that
a segment, isn't
that's
it?
That's not you. I've been doing that since season 1. So we'd either call it
Bishway.
What was that?
What?
That's
fish way?
That's
fish
bitch
way? Dish way.
Bitch what?
Bitch what?
Can you try that again, Mitch? Bitch what?
Well, if you want to go,
Bish way?
Is that
That's Maddie recording his neighbours for sure.
Bish way? Or
is that Iraqi?
No, it's a rap. Or
Iraq.
Or we can call it this. Or we can call it this.
Say what? Oh, geez, have we got a third option?
Can I just get Rhys to make something up?
Sure.
Go, Rhys.
I've got a longer version of the Bishwat if you want it.
Welcome to Maddie's new segment.
Bishway? 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 Bishway?
Bishway? It does sound like
Bishway?
I feel like I'm high.
It ends with that bitch.
What was the other one?
I don't need more editing out F-bombs in the intros.
So what I've done is
I get Ludacris's move, bitch, get out the way.
Nah.
Get out the way, bitch, get out the way.
Probably not going to work. So what I've done is I've trawled the internet to find some negative reviews of season 7.
I'll give you 2.
I can't come up with anything.
I'll give you 1 right now. F***ing Jonas ain't in it.
So here we go. So this I found this. Fallen is a boring episode of Stargate SG-1 that seems to be exhausted after 6 seasons. The death of Dr. Daniel Jackson was a big mistake of the authors. Not sure if English is their first language or not. However, his absurd and nonsense return is awful. The SG-1 fighting the ghoul Anubis is repetitive since only changed the villain. I'm guessing they're talking about Apophis there. The jokes of Jack O'Neill are turning this character silly instead of funny. Sam Carter, Teal'c Hammond, Dr. Fraser and Jonas are still okay, and Amanda Tapping is becoming prettier with age. Her hairstyle now is very beautiful. My vote is 5 out of 10. I don't know if that's for the episode or Amanda's
Signed
hair.
Signed R.C. So Cooper.
It is from Iraq.
I'm not sure.
That's from Cooper. He's just upset that they got rid of one of his characters.
And then for Homecoming, I'm as happy as anyone about the return of Daniel. I was never a huge fan of Jonas. Nevertheless, this episode is a mashup of other sci-fi movies. Daniel Jackson is reborn a la ST3, A Voyage Home. I'll have to Google that. I don't know what that is. With little to no outside help, SG-1 concocts a harebrained scheme to blow up a planet-destroying weapon by shooting into an exposed vent a la SW4, SW6, and later SW7.
That's Star Wars for laymen out there.
For the episode, 2 main arcs to be ripped off is inexcusable. Clearly they didn't realise that there was also an Independence Day ripoff there.
Yeah, big time.
This gets a 3 out of 10, only because I enjoy the little bits of larger arc material in the episode and the strong writing of the characters throughout the series.
See, I was always super excited that Daniel was back.
Me too.
I didn't care.
Nah.
That Cooper was shit.
Honestly.
From the beginning.
Bingo.
This episode could have been Daniel, like, sitting on the shitter, eating the mission reports of... Reading the mission reports.
Absolutely. Oh, eating Jonas's shit, mission reports.
Freudian shit.
Wrong. Just eating them.
These are going straight through me.
Fake news. Fake news.
Just reading the mission reports from season six that he missed. And I would have loved this episode. Like, Daniel's back. Yeah. Like, how can you not love these episodes?
Back again.
No, one of the great segments, Matty.
Bishway? Bishway?
All right, I like it now.
Yeah.
Saved it.
I can write you a terrible review of every episode if you want.
Nah, season seven.
At least funny one.
I can try.
Really? Nah.
At least
right.
A funny one.
I've already done I've already done the legwork. It's all right.
Okay.
We forgot to say Anubis survived.
Did he?
In a little
frisbee.
Pod.
Oh, his little frisbee that popped off at the end.
Yeah.
Lamest looking ship ever, that little frisbee.
I was going to say.
I don't know. Roswell
looked like Gray's the Millennium Falcon over. A bit.
Not.
3 out of 10.
Yeah. Gather round the fire. It's time for another
Graham.
Reading.
Graham's back.
G'day, buddy. It's been a while.
Jesus. Welcome to season
nice
seven, Graham.
Nice beard, mate. He's really crushing it with the beard.
So our good mate Thomasina Gibson had a chat with Corin Nemec after these episodes wrapped.
Right.
Corin was done dirty. Not surprisingly, Nemec wasn't ecstatic at giving up his regular spot on the show. I mean, what can I tell you, he shrugs. I had such a positive experience working on Stargate in Season 6 and felt very comfortable and accepted by the group on board by the fans and the show. I committed to the series based on promises that were made, and sadly, for a variety of reasons, things promised did not materialise. But that is water under the bridge. I'm just really glad I had a chance to work with Michael Shanks for more than just a couple of shots, and thought it was really neat the way the episode was constructed in such a way that Jonas and Daniel had their own adventure in relation to the overall storyline. Jonas was done dirty.
So what are they... They promised him shit and then just didn't give it to him.
Yeah, I'm wondering if he signed, like, maybe more than...
Promise you your own spin-off show.
I'm wondering if they, he signed, like, a more than one-year deal and they've just reneged on it.
Wow.
Because they do it later on to some other actors in the
They probably
franchise.
Did it with an optional second year.
Yeah, and just didn't pick up.
Promises, though. Not contractual. Is it?
Yeah, that's true, I suppose.
Mm. Oh, the old handshake deal.
Mm. Yep. But I thought it was very disrespectful the way they just threw his credit in there, like didn't even keep him in the opening credits
or even give him
a guest starring.
Yeah.
I mean, Daniel's got a new credit. He's been moved to the end now, so it's like you always want either first or last in like a TV credits. You either want to be first or last in the
end of the
list.
Yeah, because they've got and Michael Shanks as Dr. Daniel Jackson.
And he gets the end.
Yeah.
Like you'll notice when because Link's got a bit of clout now, so it's like when he does TV shows and stuff like that and movies, it'll be like and Lincoln Lewis or with Lincoln Lewis. And you see that in a lot of movies as well, the big names. It's always, if you get a with or an and or something like that, that means you're a bit higher up than just the regular kind of day player characters and stuff like that. Corin didn't even get that. He just got Corin Nemec.
Mm.
Even, like, Terrell normally gets, like, as Dr. Fraser or something like that on the bottom.
Yeah,
yeah, was that after... He was before Walter, I guess. Or was he?
Yeah.
Gary Jones?
Yeah, I was very disappointed with the production as a whole, like, to disrespect one of their actors like that. As much as I've harped on Jonas, Corin seems... Like, Corky seems like a good bloke. So maybe just had some really terrible representation at the time.
Thanks for nothing. Yeah. Get out of here.
Yeah,
like I said at the start of season six, I didn't mind Jonas because I knew Daniel was coming back, and I don't know. I feel like if he had been there for season seven and eight, he would have been like a great mainstay.
Mm.
Sure, yeah.
Like,
surely
people would have got jumped on board. I'm like, yeah, I guess we got this guy now.
Surely they could have chucked him in somewhere.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Atlantis even.
Yeah, they could have.
Well, that has its own issues there, but we'll get to that.
It's time for the Get Into Geek
Hairy Mailbag.
So we've got an email here from a Barney. Now, listen up for this, guys. Barney says, I'm the new content manager of the Stargate Command platform.
Uh-oh.
He's a big fan of the show.
What show?
Heard about... well, SG-1, obviously, not this one.
Clearly.
No, but he heard about Get Into Gate when he went for an interview for the content manager job for Stargate Command.
What?
So he's caught up. That's he's listened joke. To all the podcasts, and we've gone back and forth with Barney. He says he knows the content on the platform Stargate Command wasn't great, but he's pushing to make stuff a lot better, and hoping that we can help him out and he can help us out along the way. So yeah, I mean, we've got in contact with Barney. If you're a patron of ours, you'll know the story. Basically, it really seems like this the new content manager for Stargate Command really gives a shit, obviously more than the previous ones did, that's for sure.
We don't know who they were. Look, they probably loved it, mate.
Mate, it's like
they just got too excited.
Look, yeah, did they quit or did they get fired?
Yeah.
Ooh, drama.
Well, here's the thing. They probably weren't bad, but Stargate Origins came out and sort of ruined them.
Yeah, exactly. You can't push shit uphill. So. Yeah.
But I know there was a lot of frustration with the platform and you know, shit not working and the updates that were going wrong and stuff like that. But Barney seems to, as I said, really give a shit. He's working hard to fix it. So I'm pretty positive. I know that I've emailed him and told him what I like about Stargate Command and what I don't. Obviously, one of those lists was longer than the other, but yeah. Look, he said he's keen to do more or better content rather than just sort of the sort of Facebook's clickbait shit you see on there. But so look, from here on out, I'm gonna say I'm just gonna stay neutral for now. I'm back to neutral.
Not me, mate. I'm on board. I'll suck your dick, Barney, for $20.
It's not personal. It's like anyone's dick for $20. But
$20's expensive.
Brendan right now is that Dave Chappelle gif of him like looking for crack. He's like, I'll suck your dick for $20 so I can spend it on crack. Dick.
It is a new tier on our Patreon page.
if you remember at $100 a month, we suck your dick. Oh, wait, Dick's
Brendan's going to blow you. Oh, what? I didn't make that. All right. So I have to split it four ways.
I'll do it, but Rhys, you got to work the shaft.
You're cleaning up.
Hey, Brendan, will you suck that guy's dick for $20? Yeah, all right, just let me grab $20. Let me wallet.
It's going to hit the ATM machine. You know what I mean?
I mean, who carries cash anymore? You know?
Didn't need to say machine, but I did. The American listeners.
Automatic teller machine.
Hey, so I've got a couple here. We got a lot of chatter back for our Memento episode with the space blimpy people and... the weapon blimp for the gunships. And we were talking about, Brendan brought up the whole, you know, O'Neill and then the Colonel Commander of Prometheus kind of like ranking and Jack having a gun and stuff like that. So we were obviously the kings of fake news, just disseminating incorrect information. So we had a couple of people jump
in.
That's
how we, mate.
Joshua Shaw. Oh, no, sorry. Sorry, I've just combined both
Joshua
names.
Not sure.
Joshua Sheffield.
Joshua
Unsure. Says, just dropping a line to say hi, and I love Get Into Gate / Geek. I'll just give him getting into Geek a plug.
Oh,
there.
Geek, bitch.
Thanks,
Joshy.
It's
a porn site now.
That's why he loves it.
If you're looking for us and you mistakenly don't go to us on Twitter and Facebook and Instagram, you accidentally go to getintogeek.com, you've probably found the better source. Which is,
forget those nerds.
Wow, Mitch has really gone through a transformation.
He says, finished up Memento, the fresh maker. Why didn't we make that joke the entire podcast?
Oh, well,
I did at the start of this one.
Too busy making Minty's jokes.
Mementos.
And wanted to say that both O'Neill and O'Neill, that'd be Kurt Russell O'Neill, are full bird colonels. You see both of them in dress uniforms in the movie, and then when we meet Jacob for the first time. And Scotty Shaw follows that up and says, hey, guys, Navy has their own planes that land on aircraft carriers. My mind was f***ing blown by that. Air Force planes only land on terrestrial bases. The U.S. Navy is the world's second largest air force. I did not f***ing know that.
Oh, we're different in Australia, mate.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like, oi, Bruce, around. Give us a lift on your boat. All right. No worries, Gregory.
Gregory? one of the great Australian names.
It's Greg, mate. F***ing told you.
G-Man.
Yeah, so I found that really interesting. So I guess that makes sense that
So the Navy's...
I didn't find that interesting at all.
Navy has aircraft.
You're talking to someone who owns all five seasons of Sea Patrol. So I love me some Navy stuff.
Love a tugboat.
Yeah, oh man, I love a tug on a boat.
You're having a boat that tugs you. Jesus.
All right.
So yeah, you know, the Prometheus still is you know, like an aircraft carrier, but you know, the Air Force guy or Space Force, you know,
Space Force. Oh, the brand new Space Force.
Space Force.
Officially announced.
I don't think of it as an aircraft carrier. It's a warship.
Well, it's a carrier for 302s.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
But like, you're a carrier for AIDS.
Jesus.
I don't know. But
oh, great point.
The Titanic had some boats on it. It was a ship.
Carried people.
Lifeboats.
Lifeboats.
Yeah, carried people.
Carried lifeboats.
not enough.
Who's got another mailbag?
Billy Zane tried to steal one.
Oh, how many hards were you when you heard that Billy Zane was coming to the country, mate, for Supernova?
Supernova. Yeah.
Oh, what about John Travolta? JT.
Are you going to golly on his face?
Yeah, I'm going to try.
Golly.
Yeah. Who, Billy Zane or John
Billy
Travolta?
Billy Zane, yeah.
I think JT had wanted a little bit more than Billy Zane, but I think that's what makes
I think JT Zane might was... on Billy Zane. You know.
Maybe. What a night.
I hope so. I'll pay for that.
Are you going to get like a just like a purple, you know, Lycra like onesie and just go and get an autograph from Billy Zane?
Yeah, I'll try. Yeah. There's a great story I heard about him when he made the Phantom here on the Gold Coast. In the Gold Coast here in Australia, that I'd love to ask him about. You know?
Ooh.
Yeah, yeah. So,
lifer.
So, yeah. Got some. Yeah,
did you check out the meter maids while you're here?
Yeah. In your Phantom suit.
What do you think?
Try to pick them up, mate. Back when they were. Back when they were still PC. Megan Schiffer.
Meter people.
I don't know how to pronounce it.
Megan
Schiffer.
Megan. Maybe it is Megan.
They won.
I like Megan. I like a hard Megan.
Megan.
Rather than Megan, I like
that's
a Megan.
That's Megan. Isn't Megan it's with Megan. An H?
But the Americans won because now the Queen says Megan instead of Megan.
Oh, yeah.
Because of old love.
Yeah.
I've never understood why.
Oh, the Suits chick.
Suits chick.
Meghan Markle, I've never understood why Americans say
Gwyneth Paltrow.
Gwyneth Paltrow sister.
What are the Americans what?
They say Craig instead of Craig. They go Craig.
On the show that I worked for yesterday, we interviewed a guy whose name was Craig with an H at the end.
Oh,
what? Say that again?
Yeah, it's Craig with an H at the end. And we're like,
Craig?
Yeah,
Craig?
That's what he said. Like, he gets
maybe
on.
He's just got asthma.
Now,
what's your name? Craig?
Mind you, we were interviewing about something that our producer told us would be very interesting.
What?
Like, the guys didn't want the interview, but they said, no, we'll do it, whatever. And we get him on. Craig and then they just start, like, antagonizing before I even press record. And I'm like, sorry, how do you pronounce your name there, Craig? And he's like, he goes, Craig. And he goes, okay, just yes, yeah. He goes, it's got an H on it. Yep. But that's actually the original spelling of Craig.
I thought so, mate.
That's pretty much what they said to him. And he goes, "If you say it, you'll notice that it's got an H sound at the end. It's Craig." And they're like, "Yeah, Craig." He goes, "Yeah, Craig. You can hear the H." And they're like, "No, we can't." Anyway, joining us now is Craig.
Are you saying whip?
Say whip. Say
we never
whip.
Used to let women or coloured folk vote either, but we've changed that. So sometimes progress is good, Craig. Go with the times, buddy.
Here's a puffer, buddy. Okay, add beauty to your beast, because I can pronounce that. At Get Into Gate, in all my years of watching, I'm still confused why Daniel continues to need glasses after all his times in the sarcophagi.
Mm. Well, and not to mention this episode, he's been ascended for a year, comes back in a buffer body that still needs glasses.
Yeah.
Still has astigmatism. So.
That's Omar, just trolling him right there. Just like, cop that.
Yeah, your dick's massive, but you come really quick.
Hey, what would you rather?
Zing, got
you. What would you rather, Rhys? What you got or what you said before?
I'm happy with my short, stinky dick.
That was the setup for, I might have a small dick, but it stinks.
Essentially, you said the same thing.
Yeah, the delivery is better.
Yeah.
sounds like a character from Blinky Bill, though. Stinky dick.
My dick might be small, but it's still got mold on it.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, wow.
Rolling Stone gathers no moss. You know what I mean?
I watch Dick gathers no cheese, if you know what I'm saying.
Wow.
Oh, It's time to find out if Rhys has been paying attention.
Jeez, it's been a while since I paid attention, that's for sure. What are the rules again?
No, we got them.
We got five questions here for Rhys, the newbie. He's
30 seconds.
Never watched Stargate SG-1 before, so we'd like to test him on some short answer questions. The X-302 has been moved from prototype status and is now named the F-302.
True.
What does the F stand for?
Fox?
Incorrect. What name was given to Daniel Jackson by the locals?
Oh, the Arum.
Correct. What does Arum mean?
Naked one.
Yeah, I'll give you that. What is Jonas trying to find with the tablet?
The Lost City.
Correct. According to O'Neill, Tilk gets cranky when he's what?
Hungry?
When his blood sugar gets low.
That's what we're after. Yeah, right. He's diabetic. Yeah.
He's full diabetic now that he hasn't got Junior.
Yeah. Bloody Chitonin.
He's just smashing those eclairs. And, of course, the F in F-302 is fighter.
Fighter, yeah.
It just occurred to me,
Fox
though.
Fox was the call sign that he's going to fire. That's sort of Fox 42.
Fox, oh, that's on right.
It just occurred to me, though. It's like this whole season is like, oh, we need to find the Lost City. And Rhys already knows there's a spin-off called F-ing Atlantis.
Well, he didn't know that that's the Lost City.
Is Atlantis the Lost City? Is it really? Oh, you f***ed that, didn't you?
What? You've never heard of the Lost City of Atlantis?
No, I didn't put those two together.
Oh, my God. I can't believe I'm actually f***ing... Oh, my God.
Oh, so that's where Atlantis
starts. I just thought everybody knew, had heard that
Lost
term.
City's at the two last episodes,
I'm
isn't it?
Such a or the last episode.
Yeah, but that doesn't matter.
Oh,
but you know that.
Oh, that's disappointing.
Actually, I mean, you know that they find it now.
Stargate.
El Dorado.
Yeah, there we go, yeah. They're looking for El Dorado.
So disappointing. Anyway.
Are you really that upset, though?
I genuinely am. I just thought everybody knew that it was the Lost City of Atlantis. Oh, damn it. I don't go in intentionally trying to spoil things for Rhys.
Well.
That surprises
you
me.
You don't not spoil.
I don't even know that I want to play that sting for you now that you got those wrong after Maddie just did that.
Yeah, I feel like that was punishment enough, wasn't it?
We're going to have to, mate.
We do have to, contractually, unfortunately.
Link is in the gym right now, go, you better fucking play.
I don't want to, but here it is.
Stupid son of a bitch.
Holy shit, the Rabbitohs are back.
Hey,
probably
if
you
want to feel like you've come home, join our Patreon.
Okay.
It would feel like that. Especially now after this long break. I'm coming home.
Yeah.
Coming home.
Or if you've fallen, let us pick you back up.
Oh,
get into gate at patreon.com/getintogate.
Just like Amber Westbrook has.
Oh, Amber.
Westie.
The WB.
The Westie.
Oh, Warner Brothers.
The WB. Westbrook. WB represent.
Oh, right.
Yeah. Matthew MacArthur.
Oh, Macca.
Big Mac dog.
Welcome.
Megan Keller. Keller, very important last name in the Stargate franchise.
Kelsey.
MK.
MK. The Kellinator.
Oh. Ned Kelly.
Kelmeister.
Such is life.
The Kelvinator.
Ashley Knight.
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 Knight. This is a good one. Matty Chappie. You're right.
Matty Chappie with one of the greatest beards I've ever seen.
Chappie. Oh, really?
Yep.
Barney Kneeled?
Oh, the Rubblemeister.
With a D on the end. I wonder what he did after he kneeled.
He Fitzpatricked.
What? Where did Fitzpatrick come from?
I don't know.
Oh. And also, welcome. I missed that one.
Fitzpatrick Harris.
Fitzpatrick Harris.
I get it. Yeah. And also, welcome to Patreon, The Jaws.
The Jaws.
An idiot. We could send you stuff for free, mate.
We might have heard The Jaws on Double Jeopardy, one of the great episodes, if you want to go back and listen.
Absolutely. If you don't know what a vinegar stroke is.
I was going to say, I can't walk the condiments aisle of Coles anymore without getting the giggles.
You're going to say, without getting a bottle of vinegar.
You've ordered them as like.
I want to test that out in the mirror. See what I see if I can
buy this. I have to buy it.
What are you doing? Just practicing? trying to make myself look more handsome as I drink vinegar. If you know what I'm saying.
All right, Mitchie, wrap it up.
That is episode 135 of Get Into Gate. We will be back next week. For episode 136, we are talking Fragile Balance. Rhys, I'm looking forward to you watching this one. This is a fun episode. You'll find out why in a week. In the meantime, yeah, check us out on the socials. Get Into Gate, a Stargate podcast. Hit us up. Send us in your own hairy mailbag entry. getintogate@gmail.com. Or as Maddie said before, hit us up. patreon.com/getintogate and join the show.
Absolutely. Jump on board.
Or tweet us. We won't tweet back, but it'll be fun for you.
We just like feeling people slide into our DMs, even if we don't reciprocate the favour.
Absolutely. Yeah. At Get Into Gate.
It is a bit of a fragile balance sometimes.
That's right. All right, we'll catch you back next week. We'll get into Gate.
Bye.
We will be back.
We will be back.
With more Elton John.
This is kind of where I want to play that last line from Superman 2, you know, where he's hovering over the White House, holding the American flag, about to put it back down after Zod destroyed the place. He's like, Mr. President.
Sorry, I've been away so long.
I kind of want to have that ready, and I'm like, I don't know that I mean that. There could be another week or two here and there between now and the end of season 10.
Might just do it for shits and giggles.
Yeah. Get Into Geek.